humans, and welcome to another episode of the Cartridge and Disc Podcast. This is the morning drive, and this is your Gen X Gamer here. Guys, we're going to talk about Tencent today, and we're going to talk about them buying Techland, the studios behind Dying Light. Guys, it's been a concern of a lot of people for a long time, the influence of the Chinese government on the video game space. Just like they have, for example, an influence on the movie space. Right? Guys, China is a huge consumer of media. They are. It's only natural that these companies want to own what they're consuming. We do it here in the U.S., and any other country would do the same thing. The biggest point of contention for a lot of people is that they're afraid that the Chinese government might spy on them and, you know, put some sort of influence on these companies because of the Chinese Communist Party's policies. Every government goes after their own interest. And if you guys think that they don't do that too here in the U.S., you're absolutely insane. I think the last few years have showed you what kind of government we have. And I'm as patriotic as, you know, anybody out there. But you also have to be a realist, number one. Number two is you have to be in China. You have to know the Chinese people. If you've never been in China, I recommend that you go. If you really want to get to know a people, you have to drink with them. You have to party with them. You have to celebrate with them. And let me tell you, the people that I encountered in China were very warm and welcoming. And I always had a great time. And I didn't speak a lick of Chinese. And everybody was welcoming, especially the ladies, let me tell you. So don't believe everything that you hear. There's a difference between the government and the people that live in the country. And a lot of people confuse those things when they're talking about, you know, generalities in video games sometimes. But every government is going to spy on you, if you will, if they think that you're doing things that are against their own best interest. The difference with China here is that they're, you know, the number two superpower in the world, so they are our rivals in many ways here in the U.S. But everybody loves playing video games, and everybody likes watching movies, and that it's just natural for a lot of these big conglomerates to start buying these properties. When it comes to Tencent, they're worth about $405 billion. Why do I say that? Because I'm a stockholder, not only in Tencent, but in pretty much every other company. So, you know, I'm giving you the point of view, not only as a, you know, video game player, but as an investor in all these companies, Microsoft, Tencent, all these other companies. And what they're going to do is what they've always done, is try to make money. And the way that they do that is by producing games that people want to play. Now, the fact that they are a Chinese company, of course, is going to influence what they produce. Absolutely. Just like our government influences what we produce to some extent. Because there's things that you can't market. There's things that are censored in games all the time. And we have quite the opposite here. We have compelled speech. The government is compelling you to do certain things, saying certain things. And that's a completely different story. But it is very ingrained in a lot of Chinese policies to not be influenced by Western values for X, Y, or Z reasons. And this is not a political show, so I'm not going to get into it here. But every company has the right to follow, you know, whatever they want, and every government has the right to enforce whatever, you know, regulations are due upon their companies. Now, contrary to a lot of people's beliefs, a lot of Chinese young people, I would say most of them that I've met, are playing video games online, specifically the ones they're not supposed to play according to their government. The way they do that is, you know, usually VPNs, and they're very casual about it. Every single one that I spoke to was playing all the games that we play here in America. They were not at all deterred by the influence of whatever, you know, government body was saying for them not to play it. As a matter of fact, that just made them want to play it even more. By nature, young people are rebellious. That's why you have young people over here wanting to be communist, and you have young people in China wanting to be capitalist. It's just the way life is. Young people rebel against the authority that's imposed on them. But what is this influence going to do to the market? Well, you know, of course, Tencent is going to do what's in their best interest as far as making money, and they have to keep in line with their government, just like companies here in the U.S., like Microsoft. You just saw it go through the whole hearing with the FTC. They're not just able to do whatever they want. Countries put barriers to whatever they want to do in business sometimes, especially when they get big. Tencent has been flying under the radar here for the last few years, but at $405 billion, and as they become more dominant, not only in the mobile game market, but in the video game market in general, they're going to start getting scrutiny. They're going to start getting scrutiny as the content that they make, you know, reflects more the values of the government that, you know, is over them. And, you know, it's going to depend by country. But if they're going to market to their home country, which is a huge market, they have to reflect whatever that public wants. And you can see it with movies now. Movies are censored in order to satisfy the needs of the Asian market, of the Chinese market specifically, because you're talking about billions of people, billions of potential customers. And your job as a business is to sell to as many customers as you can. Now, famously, the Chinese public doesn't like pigmentation much, right? They're not interested in hearing stories about, you know, Jose and a couple of my cousins and me running around in the streets of East Los Angeles, or anything that has to do with South Central LA or anything like that. Famously, they edited John Boyega out of the poster of Star Wars. For that market, they're more interested in Eurocentric or, you know, Chinese Asian stories. That's what the public wants, and that's what the government does. That is what a lot of the companies do in order to serve, you know, their market. And famously, if you try to do anything else, they won't even watch you. You know, unless it's basketball related. There's figures that transcended, like Kobe. Everybody loves Kobe. But, you know, in this case, LeBron James, Curry, when it comes to sports, they're more accepting. But when it comes to media and having lead black characters or lead Hispanic characters, lead minority characters, it's not something that they're willing to accept in their media right now. And that is, I think, the biggest fear of a lot of people, that a lot of the diversity in games when it comes to Tencent is going to be not promoted. I'm not going to say that they're not going to make any or include any characters, but as far as lead characters to promote to their market, that's probably where you're going to see the influence. That is probably where you're going to see the influence, just like right now you're seeing a lot of games that a lot of the people don't want because of the influence not only of the government, right, but of social pressures here in the U.S. So it's going to be interesting to see. It's going to be interesting to see what Tencent does with this company and what is the first game that they will produce together. That really is going to be the barometer of where the company is going to go. That really is going to tell you what temperature Techland is going to go in the future and how big of an influence, now that they're going to be a majority shareholder, Tencent is going to be in that company, and how they're going to treat the American market. All right, guys. Thank you so much. I hope I gave you something to think about. What do you think the Chinese influence is going to be in the video game market? You tell me. Guys, I will catch you on the next one. Take care.